Just dump your apples right in to the bottom. Take some cinnamon rolls. I've actually got 2 pans. You're gonna dump the rest of your quartered cinnamon rolls right into your crock pot. That's 2 tubes. And now we're gonna take another can of our apples. I've chosen the no sugar added just because they taste the same and we don't need the extra sugar in this one. It's gonna be sweet enough without. Now I need you to grab from the fridge some heavy cream, please.
Heavy cream?
Yep, it's right on.
Heavy cream from the fridge. All right, here we go. Heavy cream. I can lift it with one arm. I'm pretty strong.
Good job. Now we're gonna just pour this right over the top. I'm kind of guesstimating here. I'm probably gonna have about half and kind of stir this up.
Okay.
Just so everything is covered in all the goodness. This is a 3-ingredient breakfast. We're gonna top that with some brown sugar.
Brown sugar.
There we go. Is that enough?
You tell me, it looks like enough.
And we're gonna top it off with just a little bit of cinnamon again, because I love the taste and smell of cinnamon. All right, we're gonna cover this. We're gonna take one of our grand cinnamon rolls and you're just gonna unroll it just like that. We're just gonna cut those in half. And you take those strips that we just cut and you just line them up on your pan. And I'm only using 1 can of cinnamon rolls. You only need 1 of those grands. And we're gonna take a couple Granny Smith apples. We've already cut them up into small pieces. Some ground cinnamon. Now we're gonna add a couple tablespoons of brown sugar. And this is actually the Truvia brown sugar, which does not have any calories, but you could use regular as well. There we go. And there's one other thing we're gonna add to these apples. That's some lemon juice. There's actually a fresh lemon right on top.
Okay, I can get that. It's in the fridge. There we go. Lemon is, ooh, that's weird. I'll do this right here. All right, lemon.
Great, we're just gonna cut that in half and get some fresh lemon juice.
Okay.
You only need about a teaspoon of lemon juice, and surely 1 lemon will provide that much for us.
Have you ever used that thing?
No, this is my first time using it. Can you tell?
Yeah.
It's 2 tablespoons. We only need about 1. So we're gonna pour our 1 tablespoon on the countertop and the other tablespoon in the bowl of apples. If you wanted to do this super quick and easy, even more than we are right now, you could use canned apple pie filling. But we decided to use fresh apples today.
It might have been a better decision.
Yeah, maybe at this rate. We're gonna place that on there. There we go.
Look at that.
Just dump all of those beautiful apples right inside. Now you're gonna take the ends and you're just gonna fold it over just like that and give it a press.
Okay.
You see where this is going now?
Oh,
see?
You can kind of like braid it.
Yep, this is gonna be one of those fancy bakery braids.
Okay.
Nobody will ever know that this was not coming from a bakery. You can trick them and it will be our secret.
I'm gonna tell all her friends though.
Look at this, look at how good it's looking now. So you don't doubt me, you trust the process.
Trust the process, okay.
Okay.
We'll see what it looks like at the end.
All right.
So far so good though. Look at that.
And
what are you gonna do here at the end now?
All right, we're just gonna keep folding.
Okay.
And then this one goes over just like that. Look at
that.
I told you to trust me. This is gonna be beautiful.
All right.
Now this is gonna be delicious. It looks pretty, dare I say it, even fancy. And we're gonna put that in the oven at 400 degrees for about 15 to 20 minutes until it gets nice. I've got my cinnamon rolls here and I place that right into my muffin cup. And then I kind of smash it down with my fingers because this is gonna be the crust of our little mini cakes. Did you know that's what that was for?
No.
Isn't that nice? Apple pie filling looks so good. And now you're gonna place some in each cup. So right now we've got cinnamon rolls on the bottom. Apple pie filling inside of that. I'm gonna add some pecan chips.
Okay.
Now you could add whatever kind of nuts you like. It could be walnuts, but I think pecans go really well with these little apple cinnamon cups. Just sprinkle them right on top. We're gonna add something else that's gonna be super yummy.
What's that?
That is some caramel syrup. Now this is sundae syrup. You actually get this to put on top of your ice cream sundaes. Oh. Now this is caramel, am I saying it right? I know there's different ways to say it. Caramel.
Caramel.
Caramel. And this is where it gets a little bit crazy.
That's just cake mix.
We're gonna take some of our vanilla cake mix, and I'm using a spoon actually, and we're just gonna spoon it on top of each one of these. Dry cake mix. Can you get me some butter? Happy birthday, Patricia, by the way.
Butter is in the fridge, so I can grab you some butter right here. Okay, get that out. There you go. Some butter.
Now, this is the magic ingredient I was telling you about. Because when this bakes, the butter is going to melt and spread all over the cake mix. And then it actually forms like a layer, like a crust almost.
Oh, I see. That's weird.
All right. And this is why you do not need to mix the cake mix. Because if you mix it, it's not going to work. You want it just like this. And you can see how these slices of butter are nice and thick. We want them to be a little bit thicker than usual because that, when the butter melts, will spread all over the top of our muffin cup. And if you're wondering where I get these nice little liners, people are always asking me in the comments, where'd you get these? I think we got these on Amazon, right? You don't have to use these. You could use just a regular muffin tin.
All right.
This is gonna go in the oven and it's gonna be delicious. All right, our cinnamon roll apples are ready. They've been baking inside the slow cooker here for 2 hours on low. So that's the setting. And this is only two ingredients. It's so easy. It's just apples and cinnamon rolls. I can't wait to smell this. Are you ready?
Yes. Whoa.
Wow. Look okay. Actually, this was three ingredients because we also put the heavy cream, and the heavy cream absorbed into this. You can see how they're nice and fluffy, almost like Cinnabon. Let's take our icing. You definitely have to add the icing on top. That's my favorite part. Okay, time for a taste test. Grab that bowl, please. Okay, I'm gonna scoop some out. Oh yeah, this is so nice and fluffy and so easy. I mean, it doesn't get any easier than this. You just, wow, look at that. I'm gonna catch it. Delicious. Okay, let's see if I can take a bite. I don't wanna burn my mouth.
Looks pretty hot.
I can't wait, so I'm just gonna try it. We'll see. Oh yeah. These are cooked perfectly, nice and fluffy. Everybody in your family's gonna love this, and I bet you'll be doing this during the holidays. Check this out, y'all. Look at that. Doesn't that look beautiful? You could serve this and people would definitely believe that you made something special, but there's still a few more steps because we've got that icing that came with our grands, and check this out, right over the top. Man, that looks good. How is that for delicious? Doesn't that look beautiful? And you know what? This is optional, but I thought, why not a few toasted pecans right on top as well? Just for good measure.
Fancy.
Doesn't that look good?
I'm so
Inside of these grand cinnamon rolls, we have some fresh Granny Smith apples. We had a little bit of brown sugar and some lemon. Kyle, get in here. You got a taste test this with me.
All right, I'm excited.
Here you go.
I'm excited. Oh, yes, yes. Okay.
All right.
All right, here we go. We'll make it like a show, like dinner and a show.
Dinner and a show. I love it. So I'm just using my spatula to cut this, and I think that's going to work just fine.
There you go.
Oh yeah,
big
that
finish,
worked.
Big finish, big finish.
You guys have to see how good this looks.
That looks.
Moment of truth. Look at that. Isn't that perfect?
All right.
It's sticking to my spatula.
Okay.
All right. That actually looks beautiful, y'all.
I'm excited about this. All right. This is basically just cinnamon rolls and apples.
With apples.
But it just looks so nice.
It's definitely a fancy way to do it. 400 degrees for only about 15 to 20 minutes. You want the first bite?
Sure.
It's still a little warm. Be careful.
Oh, hot.
Is it too hot?
Uh-uh.
I thought I burned you. Is it good?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Answer the age-old question. Does it make a difference with fresh apples versus canned?
I think it does, actually.
Yeah? Is it better with the fresh? Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Oh.
I think you could put, canned apples in it, but I think this is the way to go. So good.
This is delicious. I can't wait to see the pictures that you send me and post on our page showing me when you made it, too. This is a fun one.
All right. Pull it out. Here we go.
Now, when you let that bake...
But when you let that bake, this is what you end up with. Here we go.
I'm gonna take it out. These were pre-baked. And these are pumpkin filled with candy corn on top. That's why you're seeing the design. But those that we just made for you are with apple. All right? And what's great about these little muffin cups is that they just slide right out.
Look at that.
So this is our cinnamon roll. I'm gonna slice it so you can see what we got in there.
Yeah, definitely.
Cinnamon roll. This is just the dry cake mix on top with the butter. And there's a little bit of pumpkin in there. Your different layers. See, you can see the layer of pumpkin.